Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to describe and demonstrate about the antenna trainer. The order code for this antenna trainer is 10020. You can use this order code to find out the specification and to check out the queries about the antenna trainer. So for starting the proceedings, we will first introducing and describe about the main unit. This is the main unit of antenna trainer. In this, the specification regarding this main unit is it contains an RF generator which provides the RF generated output of approx 750 MHz, which is an inbuilt circuitry for this, and provision of output adjustment also provided. Now, there is a tone generator which provides the tone generated output of approx 1 kHz. The provision of tone generator output adjustment is also provided. There is a direct coupler here. You can use the direct coupler in forward and reverse direction, and the selection can be done by this selector switch provided here, and also adjustment port is provided. The antenna rotation can be measured and scaled by the goniometer provided on the front panel, which can be moved antenna from 0 to 360 degree at 1 degree of step resolution. Receiving antenna is a folded dipole type of reflector with digital meter, and 21 different type of antenna are provided with this complete setup. And there is a features of different slide bar slider type matching stub is also provided with this, and digital meter is also provided for forward and reverse indication on the front panel at a LED screen. So this is the complete setup of main unit. Now we are going to describe the receiving end and receiving unit. Also, we are offering a RF detector or the receiving unit. In this is a complete passive instrument. This can be installed separately, and this works on a battery inside, which is a plus 9 volt battery, and this is a DPM digital panel meter given on the front panel, at which you can use the mu ampere ratings to check the readings. And this is the plus minus slot to provide the oscillation and different waveforms to check from the signals which are receiving from the RF detector. The RF detector is directly mounted to receiving mast, and the detector antenna consists of folded dipole antenna as receiving element and a reflector to reduce possible disturbance to the measurement due to the reflection of waves. And display readings can be adjusted by this level varying knob, and different demodulator, receiving mast and matching stubs are the rest of the accessories, in which we are also offering some different types of BNC to BNC connector, in which two of the male connector from BNC to BNC, and this is the L type connector and a T type connector, which are required to adjust the antennas at different positions. And this is the current probe to see the current generation of the antenna, and we will also see the practical regarding with this using the current probe. Apart from that, we are also offering 17 different types of antenna, in which you can use the and see the working of different types of antenna in the antenna trainer provided. So some of them are the Yagi UDA, folded dipole Yagi UDA, folded dipole 3 element, 5 element and 7 element type of antennas, horizontal and hertz antenna, helix antenna which is provided here, and lambda by 2 phase array antenna, combined collider antenna, and some many more. So total type of 17 antenna, different types of provided, and we are also providing a user manual in which all the experiment details and the description of different types of antenna, how the working of the antenna done, and to use the antenna of and designing the different type of plots for the antenna ranges. You can also study different types of antenna with this, referring this user manual completely. So for experimenting the antenna trainer, we have a first experiment which is describing us to assemble the trainer and to perform the functional checks. So the main unit, we will first place the main unit on the table and connect power cord and RF generator, adjust the level of potentiometer to middle position, and modulation generator also we will select the switch to INT position internal, and the adjust level to potentiometer will be at the middle, and directional coupler should be also at forward position, and the FS adjustment also should be at middle position. So all the three ports on the main unit should be at the middle position before starting the kit. So we will set them to the any middle position approximately. So this is the RF generator port and directional coupler port and modulation generator port, and this is the internal input, should be at the internal position. This switch one provides the switching where it is at the up direction, this will connect with the internally, and when this is at the lower direction, this will connect it with the external input. And this is the forward reverse switch 2 for the directional coupler to provide the forward and reverse direction of this. So this is the gainometer. Now we will install the transmitting mast on the antenna. So this is the complete chrome type of stand providing for installing the antenna on this transmitting mast, and this has an inside BNC connector. So this BNC connector can easily be installed on the main unit. So, and this has the marking by which you can adjust the complete degree wherever you want to set the antenna. So we will set it first on the 0 degree. Now for sending the signals, we will using a basic dipole antenna for on the top of this transmitting mast, and then we will see the receiving end connections and receiving end installation. Now for transmitting the antenna, we will connect the main unit with a connected folded dipole antenna. So this is the folded dipole antenna. You can see the name is also written on the every antenna. So whatever your antenna you want to use, you can easily find out which type of antenna is the required. And this is the folded dipole lambda by 2 antenna. So this will be connected on the top of this transmitting mast like this. Now for the receiving end, we will install the receiving mast and we will keep it at the same distance of the main unit. So this is the receiving mast. So we will place this receiving mast at some required distance, and the receiving unit or the RF detector will be installed easily on the receiving mast by using this hole provided on the back side of this. So you can easily tighten and loosen the receiving mast properly like this, and you can tighten the screw properly so this will do not move and disturb the signal. Now this has a switch here on the right side, so by turning on the switch you can on and off the antenna trainer or the RF detector. Now we will install a BNC to BNC male type connector on the top of this receiving antenna, and followed by this we will connect the detector antenna on the top of this antenna receiver. So this is the BNC to BNC type male connector, and we will connect the detector antenna. Here you can see the detector antenna is also provided. So you can easily be connected this by BNC and align the antenna in same line, so you will receive the proper signals. Now we will first power on the kit and see the and follow the rest of the instruction described in the user manual. Now we will follow the instruction in which we should keep the base of transmitting mast such as the 0 degree position. So the goniometer should be directed towards the RF detector and also align the marker of the mast at the 0 degree position. So right now you can see we have aligned the marker of the mast as the 0 degree position, and the goniometer or the antenna is facing towards the RF detector. Now install the detector antenna on the receiving mast so that we have already installed, and keep its direction towards the transmitting mast by rotating counterclockwise. So the direction of transmitting mast is also and the receiving mast are also facing the transmitting mast that we have installed properly. And now we should switch on the main unit and we will check the display of direction coupler. It will show some reading according to the level knob at its starting. So now we will turn on the kit and this will showing us some reading on the front panel. this is right now showing 103.4 μA, and switch the RF detector on and keep the level knob at the middle position. It will show some reading also. So now we will also on the RF detector here. So this is showing some reading. So we will adjust the level. So we will get some zero reading at the middle position. Now we will vary the FS adjustment potentiometer of direction coupler, and to make the display reading of 100 microamps, then adjust the level of RF detector to show the reading of 3/4 reading of the main unit's display. Now we will adjust the directional coupler, so we will get the 100 microamps on the main unit. So this is now 99.9 and this is 100 microamperes on the main unit. Now for the RF detector unit, we will keep the directional and RF detector. This will show the 3/4 reading of the main unit display. So we will adjust this as we set the 100 on this main unit. You can see, so this should be at the 3/4 approx 70 or 75. So we'll adjust the potentiometer to reach the value about 74 75, which is the 3/4 of the main unit. So this is approx 3/4 of the main unit, 80 or 75 around. And now we will rotate the transmitting antenna between 0 to 360 degree and observe the display at RF detector. This will show some variation and indicates the transmitter receiving working and radiation pattern is formed. So now as you can see, the reading at the receiving RF detector is 87 and transmitting is 101. Now we will slowly change the direction of antenna by moving the transmitting mast, and you will get the variations in the receiving end. This is showing that the radiation pattern is formed, and as we moving the antenna from 0 to 360 degree, this is losing the signal and the radiation pattern is distorted by antenna position changing. Now we will move the antenna completely 360 degree. Now this is at the 180 degree completely. Here you will we are getting some signals again, and as we reach the 0 degree again, we will get the complete strength of the signal as the antenna aligns properly. Here you can see the signal's range is now increasing. Here this is now 0 degree and we will getting the complete signal output that we have at the starting. So this is how antenna tuner is working. So this is the basic installation type in which all the antenna or different type of antennas will work, that we install the transmitting and receiving end both, and just we need to change the antennas so we will get the proper signal and different values. Now for important notes, the following action can be take to optimum radiation at RF detector and adjustment of for antenna match. If necessary, the adjustment of antenna match may be required to optimize the maximum radiation from different antennas, and adjustment level of RF generator in case of low reading, the low gain antennas, that are some of the antennas provided from this kit, in which we have to set the RF level potentiometer of main unit at the maximum position. Right now we will working at the middle position, at the starting that I have explained, and also the reading of the DPM directional coupler can be set to 50 microamperes. At different ranges and different antennas, we have to adjust the different ranges and different values for main unit and as well as the RF detector unit also. Now to plotting the polar graph, we have to plot the graph by following the steps, in which
To plot the polar graph, the transmitting antenna start taking readings at the interval of 5 or 10 degrees and note the readings at RF detector's display. So the reading of the main unit and the RF detector unit should be taken at the per 10 degree difference, and we will convert the noted microampere readings into dB with the help of conversion chart given on the back side of this user manual. By this you can convert the readings in the decibels, and then the decibel you can plot using the decibel values a graph which is a polar graph which for degrees of rotation for antenna against the readings of dB. So you will get the gain and different values described, and this type of graph will be you get after plotting the readings by taking different values. Now for the next experiment, which is to perform the polarization test of the antennas, in which we have to set the arrangement as per the experiment last we have explained, and this is the description of this experiment provided on the picture, in which we have to turn the RF detector box at the 90 degree, and then we connect the L-shaped BNC connector provided with this kit on the top of the RF detector, and we'll mount an antenna vertically like this described in the picture. Since we have changed the plane of receiving antenna to vertical keeping transmitter antenna, and this is still horizontal plane, so the transmitting antenna is in the horizontal plane and receiving antenna is in the vertical plane, so this will give us the signal loss and there will be might be no signal. So we will use the L-shaped BNC connector provided with this kit. So we will connect the antenna using this. So we will remove the antenna from this RF detector and connect the L-shaped BNC connector, and we will turn this to the 90 degree from the main, and the antenna should be detector antenna will be connected at the vertical plane properly like this. So now antenna is in vertical plane and transmitting antenna is in the horizontal plane. So since we have changed the plane, so now we will rotate the transmitting antenna from 0 to 360 degree gradually, and we will observe that the receiving antenna received practically no signal or very less signal. So we will start the unit, also the RF detector unit. Now this is giving us the 99 degree, and the receiving end is giving us 99. Here you can see the reading or the receiving is very less. Now we will rotate the antenna from 0 to 360 degree, and so we will rotate the antenna about 270 degree right now. We will also check the reading again. So this is now showing 29.4 degree. It is some of the maximum value, and now we will again rotate the antenna to 180 degree. Here we can see the very less signals providing, and now we will reaching about 90 degree. So signal is also very less in this. So this is the polarization test of the antenna, which describes when we change the plane of both the receiving and transmitting antenna, the signal loss should be occur.
Now for the next experiment, we will going to perform the modulation test using the antenna trainer. So we will arrange the setup as the procedure explained in the first experiment in this video. As the modulation switch is at the integer int or the up position, it will select the internally selected generated sine wave for the to modulate with the RF signal at the RF out. So at the kit, this switch 1 should be at the upwards direction, and this will select the internally generated sine wave, which should be modulated with the RF output and which will be received at the receiving end at the RF detector. Now, we will observe the demodulated output signal at the out terminals of the RF detector and with the help of oscilloscope probe. And it should be a sine wave of a low amplitude and slightly distorted, but indicating that this is the information signal sine wave which is transmitted and received at the antennas. So now we will use an oscilloscope. Here you can see the signals are right now transmitting, that the experiment as and the setup is completely set as the first experiment. Now we will connect the CRO test probe using a CRO or the oscilloscope, and we will observe the sine wave signal, which should be slightly distorted. We will connect the CRO using channel 1, and this test probe will be connected on the RF detector terminal, positive negative on the front here. Now we will auto tune the CRO and adjust the voltage per divisions, and here we will getting a sine wave of very low amplitude. You can see here on the CRO or the DSO. So this is the sine wave, and which is the slightly distorted wave. Now as I turn and change the value of direction coupler and the RF generator output, we will also get the distorted output on the CRO screen. Now we will change the value of RF generator slightly. So this is distorting the output waveform as well. Also the modulation generator waveform can also distort the waveform. So as the modulation changes, the waveform also changes at different values. So this is a antenna transmitting signal. Some distortions are due to the space between the antennas and different radiations passed over there. Now as we change the switch to the downwards, here you can see the output is completely zero and the value at the detector end is also zero. So to providing the signal externally, you can use these slots to provide any of the signal by using a function generator or different generating sources with the different amplitude and the value of frequency. You can provide the external signal, modulate with this the RF generator, and the RF output will be taken at the RF detector signal. So this is how we are doing with the modulation test of the antenna trainer. Now in the next experiment, we will study the variation in the radiation strength. Now study of variation in the radiation strength at a given distance from the antenna, the detector will show a higher strength when it is at the near from the transmitting antenna and shall reduce gradually with the increasing of distance. For this procedure, we will mount a dipole lambda by 2 antenna on the top of transmitting mast as explained in the first experiment, and arrange the setup as per the procedure given in the experiment first described in this video also. Now keep the RF detector at a distance of approximately 1 feet from the transmitting antenna and align it, adjust the level of RF generator and detector so that the reading should be at 3/4 at the mains unit as we have done in the first practical. Then we will note the reading from 1 feet and then we shift the detector antenna to 2 feet away, and then we also read the readings, and then we so on change the distance from the receiving end approximately 3, 4 and 5 feet, and then we plot the graph of reading of distance, and then we see it is a linear and non-linear. Same experiment can be done with the other antennas also. Now as described in the first experiment, we have now put the receiving antenna at some of 1 feet distance almost from the transmitting and receiving end. Right now here you can see the signal is overload, so we will adjust the knob to receive the 3/4 reading of the transmitting signal. So this is 80, 85, is approx 3/4 reading. Now this is considered to be 1 feet distance from the receiving and transmitting antenna. So at this time we will note down the reading, which is we are sending 103 mm of signals and we are receiving the 82 or 84 something mm signal at the RF detector. Now we will increase the distance approximately 2 feet. Here you can see the signal strength is decreased as the distance is increased. Now we will increase the distance some more and we will seeing that the signal is right now is approximately 14 and 16 mm in the current range, and this is showing that the as we increase the distance from transmitting and receiving end, the signal's strength are weakening with the increasing in the distance. So now we will again put the receiving end nearby 1 feet of the transmitting mast and we will getting again the full signal, which is the 3/4 of the transmitting signal. So this is how we explain the variation in radiation by increasing the strength or the distance. So the strength is weakening with the distance is increasing. Now in the next experiment we will study the reciprocity theorem of the antennas. For this we will using a Yagi UDA 3 element folded dipole antenna for the transmitting end and 5 element folded dipole antenna for the receiving end. So this is the 3 element Yagi UDA dipole antenna for transmitting end and this should be connected at the transmitting end of the transmitting mast. So we will connect this antenna at the transmitting end of the main unit. Like this. You can use any of the two antennas. So this is the Yagi UDA 5 element folded dipole antenna, also mentioned at the antenna as well. You can see this antenna should be connected at the receiving end or the RF detector. Now we will turn on the power and plot the radiation pattern accordingly by changing and moving the directions of the antenna. Here we are sending 102 signal from the 102 mA signal from 0° from this transmitting antenna, and we are receiving 90 or 80 mA at the receiving end. Now for the radiation pattern we will move this transmitting antenna from 0 to 360 degrees, and at different points we will get the readings and plot the red polar graph of the radiation and read note down the all reading and plot the graph. Now for reciprocity theorem, to prove the reciprocity theorem, as the readings has been taken and the polar graph has been plotted, after that we will turn off the kit and interchange the both antennas. So now we will connect the 3 element Yagi UDA dipole folded antenna at the receiving end and 5 element Yagi UDA folded dipole antenna at the transmitting end, and after that we will get the same polar graph, almost same polar graph, and when you take the readings and plot the graph you will get same readings and almost same polar graph as provided from 0 to 360 degree rotation of antenna. So after interchanging you will getting the same graph, same plot of the polar values. So this is showing and proving the reciprocity theorem of the antennas. Now, for the next experiment, we will study the matching stub. A matching stub is a piece of transmission line which is normally short-circuited at the far end, and stub has an input admittance which is a pure susceptance, and it is used to tune the susceptance component of the line admittance. The stubs are particularly used at a higher frequency for variety of loads. For procedure, we will mount a folded dipole antenna on the top of transmitting mast and keep the setup ready as the experiment 1. So this is the description of the setup. We will add a T-type of BNC connector on the top of transmitting mast, which by using the RF cable, we will connect the matching stub from the signal, and we will observe the different values as described in the user manual. So as described in the user manual, we have arranged the experiment setup as described. So we have installed a folded dipole antenna on the top of transmitting mast and keep the setup ready as the experiment 1. In this, we are using a matching stub. So we have removed the transmitting antenna and fixed the RFT provided with this kit and the RF to RF cable to matching the stub line as per the figure 7 described in the user manual. Now we have mount the antenna over the RFT. Now we will keep the stub knob at the zero of the matching scale. Here you can see the stub knob is at the zero position, and we will observe the reading on the detector has already gone down by connecting the matching stub, and we will keep the directional coupler switch on the reverse position. So now we will on the trainer kit. Now you can see as I remove the stub connections, cable here on the main unit, right now we are getting the 10, 110, and 1111 readings. Now when we connect the stub, the reading will be goes down. Here you can see the reading slightly goes down about 5 or 4 points. This is now 108. Now we will turn this directional coupler switch to the reverse position, and this is the 62 value at the reverse. Now we will slightly slide the stub knob to the right to left, and slowly we will observe the reading on the meter on the main unit, and we will observe that the meter has showing us a minima and a maxima at some point. Now we will slowly move this towards the left, and at this time we are getting reading which is 63.3, 63.4, 63.5, 63.6, 7. Now 7 is the maximum value. Now 63.8 is the maximum value, 63.9 and 64, 65. Now it is now going down again. So we have reached our maximum value, which is 64.56. Yes, after 6 we are going down again. So now we will reach to the minimum position, which is 60.6 here, or 60.4. And now it is again increasing towards the maxima, 62.3, 62.8, 62.9. So this is the experiment from the matching stub. Now it is integrates the maximum integrates that the reverse power is maximum and line is mismatched, and we will choose the minimum point while going from right to left. This position indicates that the line is matched. Now the minimum point from right to left will be given as the line match. So our minimum point is approximately 61 or 60.5, 59.6 approx. So this is the minimum point, and this is indicates the position, indicates that the line is matched of this antenna. So this is how we use the study of matching stub using antenna tuner. Now in the experiment net, this is explained that how do SWR measurement. So for SWR measurement, you can read the theory at the earlier pages in this manual provided. The SWR is the index of mismatch existing between the load and the feeding line. In the previous experiment, we have tried to match the line by matching stub and adjusting it to the minimum display in the RF position. Now, RF position meter, the position is already position of minimum reverse power. Now we will arrange the setup as given in the experiment 7 that we have experimented in the last experiment. Now we will note down the reading of A on the main unit, which is the minimum reading. Now turn the switch to the forward, and this will give us the reading of forward power. And the SWR can be calculated by using this formula, which is the forward minus reverse reading and forward plus reverse reading divided by forward minus reverse reading. So at this point, this is the reverse minimum reading on this point, which we have found it from the minima and maximum values. And now we will change this switch to the forward position. At the forward position, we are getting 107.4. Now we will note down this reading as well, and after that we can calculate the SWR with this experiment and this formula given in the user manual. Now for the next experiment, we are going to use the antenna current sensor. This is used to measure the current in the antenna, and this device consists of a sensing loop with a rectifying diode and a capacitor. When a sensor is placed in the neighborhood of the radiating antenna element, a part of the varying magnetic flux will cross the sensing loop and develop along its voltage. This voltage, rectified and smoothed by a capacitor, will appear as a DC or the modulated DC if you are transmitting an amplitude modulated wave. Now we will follow the procedure, and we will use this current probe and the current sensor provided with this kit to measure the current value or the current voltage from the multimeter of the antenna. So this is the current probe from antenna side, and this is the current probe for output side. At this resistance terminal, we will get the value of voltage and see how the current and the signal affects. Now we will follow the procedure as described in the user manual. For this, we will connect a simple dipole antenna on the top of transmitting mast. We can connect any of the antenna which gives us the better signals, and make the unit ready as per the procedure as described as the first experiment in this video. Now connect the current sensor near to the feeding point of the antenna, and we will connect a DC voltmeter on the other end of the current sensor and note down the voltage across the resistance. Now we will move the sensor at different points from the feeding point from farther, and we will note the voltage, and we will repeat the procedure again. As the picture you can see, we have to connect the current probe as described in the user manual. For this, we will properly connect this current probe at this element here, and signals are right now transmitting. At this time, we will use a multimeter, set it to the millivolts range, and we will observe the resistance at this point. Voltage at this point. This is showing us the 10 millivolts, and at the multimeter, we will note down this reading. Now we will move the current probe approximately to the medial of this element. Now again, we will measure the voltage at both the point. Here we can see the voltage is now decreased in some value, which is now 65. Now we will position the current probe at the last end of the element. At this position, we will again measure the voltage, which is very low right now, which is approximately 10 millivolts or 9 millivolts at the DMM. So this is the value of antenna from the generating point or the transmitting point is giving us that the voltage decreases as we move away from the feeding point. And now we can connect the 5 element dipole antenna or transmitting mast and connect the current sensor at active element, this antenna not the voltage reading. Now we can change the current probe at different elements of this antenna and see the voltage difference or at different elements and different values. This is just showing that the current of the generator and the antenna from the leading point is higher at the leading point, and as we move the from the farther from the antenna, the voltage and the current are decreased. We have described some of the antennas and some of the basic principles of the antenna trainer, and we have provided 17 different types of antenna with this trainer kit. You can do all the experiments described in the user manual also, and to study detail in the detail about all the antenna types of different types of antenna. All the practicals and the polar graph you can plot using and following the referring the user manual. In this, all the different experiment with all the different types of antennas are provided. You will get the values and the different plots described in the user manual. So while practicing with this kit and using the referring the user manual and doing the experiments, if you find difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for any kind of support. Thank you.